My name is Dr. Don Pedro Obasekia. The Riga settlement, or whatever they call it, which is to resettle nomadic Fulani herdsmen in states across the Federation, is at best a new colonial initiative of the federal government. What makes it even more daring is the fact that the federal government is not taking into consideration the peculiar nature of the places where you want to settle people who are not indigenous to those places. See, we are Nigerians and everybody has a right, however, wherever, to move or cohabit in any part of the country. That is okay. But land is a very sensitive issue across the world. You cannot just by fiat legislate that areas, swaths of land, be given to nomadic herdsmen of a particular tribe across the nation. It's a deliberate attempt to change the entire demography of the country. You are moving millions of people, spreading them across areas, taking lands that are native to people, and then you are giving it to persons who, those persons who owned the place originally, have not willingly ceded those territories though. That is colonialism. That is taking our native lands by fiat. You see, the indigenous peoples of Edo and Delta, we are the ones who are most scared. One, our population is threatened. Two, our way of life, our culture will be threatened. Three, the persons you want to now settle on our lands are persons who already have a history of killing our people. Now you are legalizing their ownership to lands that ab initio were not theirs. So, and the only way to react to this is to resist. That is very simple. It is to resist, because you cannot forget that Nigeria is a signatory to the United Nations Charter. We are a signatory to the Human Rights Charter. We cannot now, as a people, under a government that appears to be insensitive to the clamors, to the yearnings and aspirations, to the cries of marginalization of particular swaths of the country. So I think it is not only ill-advised, it is at best a criminal, devilish initiative. And the only way is for the government, to the federal government, to immediately rescind that decision. If it's a government that listens to the people, if it's a government that listens to those who own the land, it reminds me of the song of Sunny Okosun, Papa's Land. We want to know who owns the land. The land under question belongs to the indigenous peoples. It must be clear that our youth, all our teenage youths, must be vigilant at this point in time, because it's almost like a clarion call for you to defend that which is yours. Number two, it's our elders and our leaders, particularly the governments of both Edo and Delta states. They must stand up now to be counted. Our legislators can no longer play like it's business as usual. The government has come out in clear terms that this government has, instead of being a government for the people, that is all Nigerian peoples, by the people, for the people, of the people, it is turning out and panning out, not only from the body language, but of the deliberate policies of this government, to be a government for a section of the country, by a section of the country, and about a section of the country. So that must change. You see, we the Midwest peoples of Edo and Delta, we are insistent on a deliberate refederalization, a deliberate restructuring of the Nigerian Federation. The Federation is failing, and we cannot pretend, we cannot go to bed, lie down and sleep while the roof is on fire. The roof is on fire. The only problem now is that many of us, or the only advantage, is that many of us are yet to be the direct victims of all these marauding acts. A few months ago, we thought it was just in the news, but they've entered large swaths of Ovia Northeast and Ovia Southwest. A couple of days ago, Okada Junction had to be held to a standstill. In as far down as Ugeli area of Delta State, not to talk about the cries of the governor of Delta State, His Excellency Dr. Ifeanyi Okowa, he has screamed over this. So there is no gainsaying the fact that we are a race under threat. And this is an existential threat. And the only way to face it is to wake up. I beg all Bendelites, all Midwesterners, all persons of Edo and Delta extraction, from all the 12 ethnic nationalities of the Midwest region, to please gird yourselves and guide our land. There is no land for any Ruga settlement. There is no land to resettle Fulani herdsmen in our land. And there is no way the federal government, who constitutionally does not own the land. The land belongs to the government of the state. Hence, if you want to have a certificate to occupy land, a certificate of occupancy, it is granted to you by the state government. So why is the federal government all of a sudden playing policeman when it lacks the jurisdiction to do so? So this is key. We must rise up and defend what is ours. And that is the position of the entire Midwestern peoples of Nigeria. And as Nigeria's legitimate fourth region, the only region created by this country, legitimately and constitutionally, we have a right to scream to rooftops so as to preserve our commonwealth and protect our people, protect our culture, protect our women and farmers, and protect our way of life. Thank you.